Hey boys, hey girls, welcome to Louisiana Cajun Recipes. Ricard light check. No, don't be stupid, camera. I got a good SD card in it this time. I'm wearing suspenders. I lost so much weight, my britches won't stay up no more. They fall down around my knees. But see, they fine because of the suspenders. Oh boy. I'm gonna make some more of them short ribs. Beef short ribs, they're really good. And the only ingredient that goes in it is a little cooking oil, salt, pepper, beef stock, wine, and some tomato paste. And boy, it makes a wonderful gravy. I'll show you how it's done. But first, let me show y'all a little tip. I bought some oven lights. The light in my old oven was burnt out, I thought. But actually, it wasn't burnt out. The light works. See, it's on. I guess you can see down there. Light on, okay? And the glass was so black, I said, shit, I'm gonna have to clean it because you can't even see up in there. Now, you see that little stop detent right there? All oven doors, you grasp it on each side by the handle, and it comes right off. And then you can lay it down flat on a flat surface. See, they got these two little arms down here. I guess you can see down there, one on each side. Don't let them go back in, because you're gonna have to get some pliers or a screwdriver and pry them out. They're on a strong spring, because this door is pretty damn heavy. And put it back on. You simply line it up. Come on, line up. Oh no, look, I'm gonna snap one shut. Let me go get some pliers, but you ain't gonna pull it out with your fingers. Cut. You recording stupid? Any kind of pliers will work. Whoops. There we go. Hard to get a grip on it. So, line your door up. That means the other oven's ready. And the door back on. Simple as that. Turn the light off. Then you don't have to get on your knees and clean the door. Now the rest of the oven, well, that's a different story. But what you can do, like it says to do with my new oven, which you got a self-clean mode, but that's hard on them elements, is you take a pan, a deep pan of water, and put it in there on the lowest rack on bake. And it's gonna boil that water, it's gonna steam up inside the oven. And turn the oven off, leave the pan in there. As soon as it's cool enough, get in there with one of them Scotch-Brite, one of them sponges, look like this, it's wet. One of them little scrubbing toughy brushes, and it'll wipe right out. That steam will make all, it'll loosen all that stuff, unless you ain't never cleaned it and it's 20 years old, then you're gonna have to get some chemical after it. Which is what I had to do to that glass. I sprayed it on last night, some of that oven cleaner, and let it sit overnight, and it wiped right off. My wife said, why you ain't do the whole oven? I said, hit a can, hit a scrubber, have at it. I ain't doing it. I ain't getting down there. My back ain't that good. So, what I got here is four heads of garlic, some beef stock, the paste, salt and peppers over there, and I'm going to rinse these and then paper and then dry them off with a towel because they don't brown with water on the outside of them. And, then go fry them down in a pan I'm gonna cook them in. Which is this large, it's a large cast, porcelain enamel coated cast iron pan. And it come with these little rubber things on it so it don't chip the inside of the pan during shipping. And I leave them on there for storage. That way it won't, but you gotta take them off to cook with. I dropped one too. Okay? So, we're gonna fry down in that. Just be gentle when you're putting the lid on. It's made by Lodge. A bunch of people make them. I caught this one on sale, I think. I want to say I paid maybe $39 for it, whereas they normally 60-something. At least online. Let me get to working on the prep, and I'll show y'all what we're gonna do. Cut. Action. So why did I say wet meat don't brown? Well, it does brown, but the water gotta evaporate first. So, rinse them. As you know, the butcher done had his hands all over them. And then dry them best you can. You need more paper towels, get more paper towels. Try to dry them off good. There, I'm happy with it. All right, now, go over there. I done wrenched some garlic in the zinc. And some of the paper come off. You know, if you want to pull it off, that's fine, it don't matter. But we gonna press this through a fine screen strainer and press all the goodness out of here. But I'm gonna cut them in half first. That way, across. We're gonna brown them too. But first, let's salt and pepper these on both sides. Pretty heavily. That was the salt. Here's the pepper. Let me flip them over. And these are boneless, like I said. If you get the bone-in ones, do it. These was on sale, so I bought the on-sale special. Both sides, okay? You don't need to watch all this. Cut! Action! Now, I got about 2 tablespoons of Earl in there, a quarter cup, something like that. And it all ain't really hot enough yet. It'd be all right. Don't worry about it. It's going to come up to temperature quick, because this is a gas cooktop. And we're going to roll them around and brown them on all sides. Okay, look, the granddaughter made a plate of pawpaw spaghetti and meatballs. Ain't that nice? Yeah. Let me go cut them garlics in half.
I'm gonna do a little prep work. That knife ain't gonna cut it, boy. Go get a good knife. I need to sharpen that one too. I know that for a fact. Anyway, that's chef's knife. I don't use them too often. I don't usually do a whole lot of. The CIA just wanted to fight me on that garlic. Now, here's a little sauteing that meat. And
now flip them over. Not with that. With this. Get them on their sides too. Come on, turn, son of a boy.
Now this is sped up, I think about 4 times. Try to get it brown on all edges, if possible.
All right, once you got a nice brown color on all sides, and the sides of the pot are the hottest. The center is not as hot because the flame on this gas oven spreads out, wants to roll up on the sides. So whoever said cast iron cooks evenly is full of crap. It holds heat for a long time. Longer than a stainless or aluminum pot because it's cast iron. But as far as everywhere being hot all at the same time, at the same temperature, is wrong. It's incorrect information. You don't know what they're talking about. All right, so once you got them good and brown on all sides, go ahead and remove them. If the grease is popping at you, it means it's too hot. See, you got a nice color on them. Just gonna put them in the lid of the pot. Look at all that yumness in the bottom of that pan. Now, if you want to defat it some, now is the time to do it. Cut your heat back some so that flame don't come up on you. And you can go ahead and get some of the grease out of here. I ought to bend the handle on this spoon. There, now that's a defatting spoon. But we don't need that much. We'd end up having to take it out later. All right. And let me get the fire back up on it. We're going to end up bringing this into the oven. Let's drop our garlics in there. Whoa. If you don't like garlic, you might not want to make this. But I love garlic. And no, you can't have too much. So, put them four whole heads in there, paper and all. Let's brown that down. Sweat that garlic.
You can kind of just stir it around good. And you can shake off some of the loose paper, like I'm doing, just removing the paper, getting it out. We're going to strain it in a bit, as stated.
Let's add some tomato paste. Stir that around in there. Next, we're going to add some vino, and that's going to deglaze the bottom of this pan. Uh-oh. May have to go get pop another top. Be sure and scrape up all them brown bits you can. That ain't burn. That's what's going to make this gravy so flavorful. Did I bump you? Good thing I ain't got my stick. Who remembers the stick? Now, watch this trick. Look over here. Let's see if I got the camera aim right. Yeah. Look, a magnetic can opener. See that? Everywhere there's a corner in sheetrock, there's a metal strip. They're running there to reinforce it. So, now you know. How about that? Let's pour our stock in there. All right, wore this can open out. We're going to use all of this. Get our meat back in. stir it around and bring it up to a simmer. Then I'm going to go put it in a 350 degree oven for about 2 or 3 hours. And the oven heats more evenly. It heats from top to bottom all around. Whereas the stove just heats from the bottom and kind of up on the sides a little bit. Not up too high. See that handle, I can touch it. And once it's simmering, let's go ahead and put the lid on it. And put it in a 350 degree oven. Yum. Now you can go play online or something. Watch TV, watch a movie, and pick up after yourself. Like I'm doing. What else I gotta pick up? That's it. What do you serve it with? Serve it with rice, serve it with mashed potatoes, serve it with french fries. Who cares? Serve it with something. What kind of vegetable do I want? We have some kind of peas or beans, something green. I think I got some spinach. I fry up some bacon, about a half pound of bacon and one spinach leaf. That's a salad. That sounds good to me. Yum. Oh, this was just an inexpensive bottle of Cabernet Sauvignon. A dry out red wine is what you want to use. Okay. You could use white wine in it too, or clear wine, or put use a dry wine in this. There's some other dishes that you can do this with a sweet wine or a port. Good imported port from Portugal. I think from Spain. But it's different. It's more of an Asian dish with the soy in it and stuff like that. But that's all this needs. It don't need no more. Except for when we strain it. We're gonna use where is it? Come here, boy. I'm actually gonna use the bigger one. I'm gonna use one of these and press that stuff through. Hey, boy. With one of these, something to press it through with, and I got a bigger one. This one may work though. That way, all the paper gonna stay behind, and only the goodness gonna come out. The garlic. We're gonna do that over something to catch it with though. So we can pour it back in the pot. You knew that, huh? If not, you can just, you know what? A bore. Stay stupid. You can just stay stupid. Nah, I said it. If you didn't know any better. What you gonna do, waste all that goodness? Recording, check.
What?
Okay. This is reduced quite a bit. And we need to get the meat out. So let me do that. Ooh, released a lock, huh? And look, it's starting to fall apart. I figured that much. After baking for about, 2 hours, let's remove our meat and pour off our sauce and catch all the garlic and strain it. I want to say we run it at 8x speed here because this was a long video. Do it over the sink. Yeah, otherwise you'll have to make a mess. Pyrex colander, bowl up underneath to catch the juice. And we'll get us a little soft silicone spatula and mash it through.
mash, mash, scrape, scrape, get the goodness off, and continue till you get all of it out you possibly can. And you got to put a little bit of pressure. You scrape it all the way around to get the stuff off the bottom. That's the good stuff. It's going to thicken the gravy up too. And it's just garlic in there. It's been sauteed in that wine and yumminess. See, here's some on a spatula in this next little shot. There, that's the stuff, the goodness. Yum.
Look how thick and rich that gravy done got. And look, I lost a little bit too on the side. I don't know if you can see down over on this side in the zinc. And just a little bit though. About a good teaspoon. This is delicious. You can eat this on ice cream if you get it cold. Or put it in your coffee. Yum. It's hot right now, but I got a taste. I'm going to leave it alone. I ain't going to do nothing else to it. If you change the recipe, it ain't going to taste this good. So, I made it before exactly like this. I'm going to put our meat back in here and put it back in the pot. And I got to sample a little piece of this meat. Here's a little piece calling my name. Look, watch here. See how it just busting apart like that? Oh, yum. Man, the flavor. It explodes in your mouth. Mmm. Yum. My dog whining because she smells this. See, she knows she probably ain't gonna get none. That's her way of begging. Get your meat back in there, fix some sides, and keep it warm.
Getting the meat back in at high speed. There we go. Now this came out fork tender, but this piece has got a little piece of fat running through it, but you see, you just push right through with the fork. And see that one there has got a little hunk of fat or something in it that I can't push through so easily. But it jumped right in my mouth. Yes, sir. Mm-hmm. You better believe it. And there's that paper that I removed from the sauteed garlic. And there it is in the pot, cooking down. Or the straining principles. Yum. This is rich and delicious. I mean, fine eating. Real fine eating. It is with some butter beans and that gravy on some popcorn rice. Cajun popcorn rice, that is. It is a little random shot of my Christmas tree. Or one of them. And for New Year's Eve, we had the cabbage casserole and black-eyed peas and cookies and all kind of stuff for desserts. With garlic butter griddled hamburger buns. Yum. Perfect match. A boy, a girl, a pie.